Did you know more people died of heart disease last year than ever before? What the heck is going on and what can we do to protect our cardiovascular systems? Hi, I'm Danny Curtin. Thank you for joining me. Today, we're taking a look at some of the newest research about a not-so-popular supplement that, according to this study, is able to manage plaque buildup as well as cholesterol and triglyceride levels in the cardiovascular system. Now, this is only one of the newest studies, but I have a stack of reports right here that show this supplement's effectiveness for a variety of health challenges. I've got blood pressure. I've got blood mobility. I've got fibrinogen levels, deep vein thrombosis, hardening of the arteries, red blood cell aggregation and whole blood viscosity, and I've even got spike protein breakdown, and the list goes on and on. If you're interested in any of these studies, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out when I do cover them individually. Now, moving on, let's get back to the first question I asked. What can we do to protect our heart health? Naturally, I jumped online like so many people do, and both WebMD and the Mayo Clinic have similar tips. They say it's easy. All you got to do is eat healthy, exercise, watch your weight, manage stress, don't smoke, take your prescription meds properly, limit alcohol, and eat less salt. All of these guidelines are important. Well, I mean, almost all of them, right? But aren't there plenty of people that live by these strict guidelines that still wind up succumbing to some type of cardiovascular condition? Especially now, every time I turn around, someone is dropping with heart issues, and many of them are way too young. Surely there must be something else we can do. If you saw one of my recent videos about healthcare cost savings, you know that millions of people have been supporting their heart health with not only good diets and exercise, but also with natural supplements like vitamin K, fish oil, vitamin D, and magnesium. But there is another large cohort of people, including myself, that have been actively taking care of their heart with a highly effective enzyme. Now, this enzyme comes from a probiotic, and it literally has blood cleansing effects. And the best part is, you can pick this enzyme up anywhere dietary supplements are sold. Now, this new study on nattokinase stuck out to me because participants in the study took over 10,000 fibrinolytic units of nattokinase per day, which is much higher than the typically recommended 2,000 fibrinolytic units per day. And participants had to be considered unhealthy, which gives us a really good look into the effectiveness of this enzyme. Had this study been run in the United States, the participants would have had to be considered healthy in order to get IRB or government approval. Now, the study I'm referring to is called Effective Management of Atherosclerosis Progress and Hyperlipidemia with Nattokinase, a clinical study with 1,062 participants. Essentially, they looked at plaque buildup in the carotid arteries as well as high blood lipids like cholesterol and triglycerides. So first off, I don't want anyone to be misled. This study is not a double-blind placebo-controlled study. There are many studies on nattokinase that are double-blinded and placebo-controlled. I'll include links to everything I have in the description below, but this study does have a small control group that took about a third of the amount of nattokinase as did the study group. And the results, well, they're incredible, especially since this is one of the longest studies on a diseased population taking one of the largest doses of nattokinase for a study protocol. So during the study, participants took 10,800 FUs of nattokinase daily for a year. 100% of them had a high blood lipid profile. Essentially, they had high cholesterol and or high triglycerides. And 64% of them had atherosclerosis or arterial plaque buildup in the carotid artery. Now, here are the results. After 12 months of taking nattokinase daily, 95% of the participants improved their total cholesterol levels, and 85% improved their triglyceride and LDL or bad cholesterol levels. Now, 66% of the participants showed a decrease in the size of their carotid plaque, with some decreasing by up to 36%. That is a huge improvement. And 77% of the participants showed improvement in the intima media thickness, which is a measurement of the thickness of the arterial wall. It's a common measurement used to determine atherosclerosis risk. I also found it interesting, but not surprising, that exercisers had better overall outcomes than non-exercisers. Obese patients had more prominent benefits from nattokinase than non-obese patients. And The benefits of nattokinase were slightly stronger for those that also took vitamin K with the nattokinase supplementation. And finally, the control group. Those that took the smaller dose of 3,600 FUs per day had positive but much less significant cardiovascular outcomes to those taking the full dose. Okay, hopefully that gives you a pretty good idea about what the study says. Please check it out when you have some time. It's posted in the description below. So now what? You might be saying to yourself, this sounds all well and good, but is this nattokinase enzyme safe? Bottom line, yes, this enzyme is extremely safe. Nattokinase has been tested in multiple randomized double-blind human clinicals with no significant adverse events ever. It has also been shown to be non-toxic in a series of studies that administered extremely high doses for long periods of time, like in the study we just reviewed, which administered nattokinase for 365 days. And in the real world, nattokinase has been consumed in the Japanese food natto for centuries, some say as far back as 500 AD. And in terms of a supplement, nattokinase has been sold in capsule form since the 90s. And personally, I've been taking nattokinase on and off for recovery and heart health for at least the last 15 years. Now, if there were the slightest safety concern of extreme adverse events or injury, the FDA would gladly take this amazing ingredient away from us. I do have to mention some possible contraindications, however. For those of you that take blood thinners or have any type of diagnosed cardiovascular disease, I strongly encourage you to talk to your doctor before taking any type of systemic enzyme, especially nattokinase. Now, I haven't seen any daunting literature or testimonies about the negative effects of their combination. However, in theory, taking a blood thinner along with nattokinase is similar to giving a blood thinner to a child that doesn't need a blood thinner. Some type of bleeding issue could occur. So please talk to your doctor first. Now, with that said, remember, nattokinase supports our own blood cleansing system. It does not completely disrupt the coagulation cascade in the way a blood thinner like aspirin or something stronger like warfarin does. And don't be afraid to talk to your doctor. Remember, they work for you. And if they treat you like a number, maybe it's time to find somebody else. And the final step here, based on the research that I've seen, I am promoting nattokinase as a supportive supplement for optimal cardiovascular function. In no way am I stating that this enzyme is a cure for any of the ailments from the studies I just presented. With that said, if you are healthy and concerned about your heart, you should start to support the blood cleansing process with a strong nattokinase product that has more than 2,000 FUs per capsule. This isn't necessary, but if you're trying to take a larger dose like in the study we reviewed, normal products, which are typically about 2,000 FUs per capsule or less, will require 5 or more capsules just to get to the 10,000 FUs per day. So you should find a product that doesn't include any fillers or excipients like silicon dioxide, magnesium stearate, or titanium dioxide. Essentially, aside from the capsule, which is usually listed as cellulose, you shouldn't see anything else listed with the other ingredients. Whether you take my recommendations or not, adding nattokinase to your daily supplement routine is one of the most important decisions you can take to keep your cardiovascular system functioning optimally. The first product I'm recommending is Neprenol AFD. Now, this is a blend of multiple systemic enzymes and it includes 15,000 FUs of nattokinase per capsule. So it's extremely potent and it's extremely clean. The cool thing about this product is it not only supports the cardiovascular system, but it plays a role in assisting with recovery, supporting normal blood sugar and healthy digestion. But if you'd like to go for pure nattokinase, then I'd recommend Nattovena, which is an extremely clean product as well, and it offers 4,000 FUs of nattokinase per capsule and nothing else. Aside from the Neprenol blend, Nattovena is the strongest individual nattokinase product I have found. And that's it. If you enjoyed this content, please like and subscribe so we can continue to spread the word about taking care of ourselves naturally. Again, I'm Danny Curtin. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.